Laser cut clear acrylic panels and 3D printed parts come together to cover each other's weaknesses. Is this the best of both worlds? Let's see some experiments. Perfect transparency is something that you can't get from a 3D printed part, but it's something I got used to working with because laser cutting at the local shop was my main method of production before I got myself a 3D printer. I could get volumetric parts by assembling layers of various sheet materials like plastics or wood. 3D printing overcame this limitation of flat layers, and I could just go wild on the shapes and build everything in one piece, but it didn't completely replace laser cutting. For transparency, perfect surface smoothness, or everything that was basically a flat layer, I would still go back to it. So let's see if the two worlds collide, or will they merge? Experiment number one. This one was a complete success. It's a piece of a puzzle in my escape room and it's been under heavy use for more than 1 year now without any signs of that plastic coming off. The limelines of PLA were printed on top of the laser cut acrylic panel. I started by first sketching the acrylic rectangle, which was easy as it was custom cut to my own dimensions. Around it I built a fence, leaving a bit of a tolerance gap. Then I sketched the actual design that will be printed onto the acrylic panel. Even at this point I'm thinking in terms of what I plan to be the layer height and the nozzle diameter. I use a 0.6 nozzle, so I'm making all those lines to be 1.2 millimeters wide to have a perfect 2-passes print. But I need to get this all into the slicer together, which is why I need to trick Fusion 360 into letting me do that. I can't combine solid bodies that don't touch each other, nor can I export to mesh more than one at a time, but it does allow me to combine mesh bodies together, so I'll jump through that hoop now. Exporting, now let's move into Prusa slicer. I want to make sure the artwork is above as I lay down the part. It's hanging there nicely in midair right now, which is the proper way. That's how I want it. Now we need to take care of another aspect. The hot end melts plastic. So I want to make sure that it moves at a bit of a distance from the acrylic surface, and this is done by Z-hopping. I'm using 0.2 layer heights and I want to print 2 layers for the artwork. Now I need to add a color change to have a pause in the print, and it's pretty significant when that will happen. You might have noticed the fence has a weird shape on one side, and this is when that comes into play. The section going more to the outside is rising above the rest of the fence for 2 layers, and the idea is to wipe and prime the nozzle after the pause and before printing the artwork. This also means that we'll be printing below the height of the acrylic panel for 2 layers after it's been placed in, which is why we're going a bit further outside. Looking good, let's start the print. Printing the fence first. Ready, time to carefully place the panel in. I don't need very tight precision on this one, so the fence is a bit loose, but as long as the panel is not warped too much, it will all go smoothly. Remember, the hot nozzle is able to absorb some tolerance by melting into the panel if need be. The fact that the hot nozzle will melt the acrylic part a little bit is also what fuses the printed part into the panel, creating a very strong bond, and I really mean very strong. But don't take my word for it, take my vaguely scientific demonstration. I'm building a finger handle to go on top of a spare acrylic piece that I have, giving it some reasonable contact surface and a finger size hole. How much do you expect this will hold? Well, let's start small. I did skip the gym a couple of times 10 years ago when I used to work out, but I promise I'm putting every bit of force into this. It's time for the clamp down. Ha, get along, time for the clamp down. Ha, get along. Oh, come on, I just flexed. That's gonna be embarrassing if I don't do it. Nope. I mean, at this point, it's just getting stupid. There you go. I think this proves the point. In the end, the 3D printed part was the weakest point. But I mean, I could have been more generous on the infill. One last test. What if I bend the acrylic away from the part? Yep, that's the brittle nature of acrylic. And yeah, those are detached pieces of finger hanging. Here's another example. This was actually the first test where I did a very small fence, and you can tell I was nervous that it might get dragged around by the nozzle because I was constantly holding it by hand and having glue stick underneath. That was totally overkill. I'm not doing that anymore. And that's what the lack of Z-hopping looks like. A travel line scored onto the surface. PCB Way is chipping in to support me make this video. And they are relevant in this context because not everyone has acrylic cutting facilities locally. CNCing acrylic is the next level from laser cutting, if a bit more expensive, mainly because you get cleaner edges, but you also can go three-dimensional on the engravings. On the other hand, don't go too crazy on the details, because the milling bit will always be larger than the laser beam. PCB Way will do the CNCing for you and deliver to your door. Now back to our video. Experiment number 2. I wanted to have a safe way for my baby to interact with small pieces of various shapes. So I made this simple maze shape, then trapped everything permanently inside with a transparent window. This one is not that novel, I've seen it done before, and that's actually what I want to underline. None of this is tricky, and you shouldn't be afraid to apply it. There's no special tweaking needed, just some Z-hopping to protect the surface, and it's all pretty tolerant when it comes to precision. The color change or the pause needs to be right before starting to print the lip that goes above the panel. And off to the printer! Now I printed the pocket for the acrylic panel and I'll just seat it in there. But first I need to put in the goodies! If you recognize the acrylic panel, this was also the first time I did this. I definitely don't need to press that hard and risk dislocating the print. Just make sure it went all the way down in the pocket. And this is it. There's no way my baby will get hold of these small pieces. I really doubt that even I could with my bare hands, to be fair, because that is one completely solid piece right now. Experiment number 3. I needed a transparent cover over that curved surface. Acrylic sheets can be easily formed when heated to the right temperature. And I have a heated bed. It could reach 160°C, right? Right? Could it? I mean, let's try. Will it ruin the bed? Will it demagnetize my magnets? Demagnetized magnets suck. I think I'm starting to regret this. Oh, thank God. I guess the printer is smarter than me. I'll have to wait a bit for the food to be ready, but I'll do it properly. No more wild ideas. I got the acrylic piece warmed up in the oven. I place it quickly over the curved surface and it forms beautifully. That looks great and it's functional too. I guess what I'm trying to raise awareness for is that laser cut acrylic can be a great addition to your 3D printer. I hope this was useful. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see a part 2 for this. I already have some ideas in mind. Catch you in the next one. Catch you in the next one.